Seems pretty peaceful so far.
Don't worry, it gets better. After this, I'm gonna play the Hobbit theme.
Is this the Bing Xiao Xiao thing?
Yeah, but it's better.
Oh, okay. Some of that.
Right, here it comes. Welcome to Minecraft, the father of battle royale games, the education system when schools couldn't suffice.
Dedicated wham, I should have to server.
I'm sorry, could you please repeat your question?
Dedicated wham.
And still, one of the most advanced games of all time.
Wow, it's just like real life, man. What the?
Now I know what you're thinking. Why are you making a Minecraft video? I've probably seen this million Minecraft Let's Plays, but let's be honest, have you seen a communist Minecraft Let's Play? I don't believe so, so that's why you clicked on this video. It's a new experience. Alright, let's go find a village to establish a peaceful trading relation. Also known as we're gonna burn it to the ground. Now I know what you may be thinking, that's not very communist of you. Communism is all about sharing and hours and yeah, stuff like that. Now you have to keep in mind, this is the early stages of our communism in Minecraft, so it was still in the development phase. We were planning it out, we were planning the government system.
Is it a lava pool, or is it just a fall?
It's a lava pool. We can do ritual sacrifice now. At this point, we're starting to get hungry, so we had to get some tools and establish a good food source before we could go mining, so I proceeded to mass murder the entire pig population for this local ecosystem, therefore destabilizing it and leading it into chaos. Actually, I need to kill him. I'm already half hungry.
How? Yeah. Stop running.
I wasn't running.
You're running right now.
I fell off the cliff. After looking around our spawn for like 5 minutes, we finally found a cave which had iron at the beginning, which was a huge step up from using stone stuff, because we could mine stuff faster for one, and we could find diamonds and actually mine them, which is, you know, mine diamonds, kind of the goal of Minecraft.
Mine diamonds!
But we did find a mine shaft, which you would see led to some difficulties within the communist Minecraft party. I'm so good at finding caves because I secretly locked 9 people in one in the past. They call me the caveman. Oh, I found a mine shaft.
Sick. It's eating our dead brothers.
Is there something wrong with that?
What have we got here?
Oh, that's a mob spawner!
Is it a cave one or just a normal one?
It's a cave spider spot.
Okay.
I don't see no connection. Are you in?
No. Barnett messaged me. I think he's gonna join us.
With the addition of another idealist to our party, this is where the spokes of civil war began, due to conflicting ideas. But before a civil war could actually start, we had to wait until he could get back into the server. So we had a very productive conversation in the meantime.
Spot of a mosquito zapper.
Oh, don't do that.
Wait, hold up.
Yeah,
you have a mosquito zapper in your house?
Yes, and for some reason I decided to-
What the fuck, you living out in the woods?
No, I don't. I live in-
No, hold on. This man has an active mosquito zapper in his house and where he's playing games. What are you trying to keep away?
Mosquitoes, you win.
Friends? You can like wave it at them if they walk into him. Yeah, get out of here. I'm playing Minecraft. Get out. I'm gonna zap you.
Actually,
get the heck out of my room, bro. I'm playing Minecraft.
Shut up.
He's trying to ward off any social contact of the real world with his mosquito zapper. Has it hanging right in front of the doorway. So whenever somebody walks in, they get zapped.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna...
Hold up now. Hold up. You know what I just realized?
What?
We have the red, white, and blue in our Discord.
Oh, yeah.
We gotta change this. What? Alright, boys. We fixed it. We have ended capitalism. When we hopped back in the server, we began going over our agricultural policies, our regional and land dispute policies, our land boundary policies, and going over our government policies compared to other worldwide government policies to, you know, make sure we are off to the right start, not developing anything that shouldn't be going that way or anything like that. Wait, what? Hold up.
Advancement. North Korea, North Korea is now a part of America, or I should say Ohio.
Does that mean Kim Jong-un's a senator? If he's part of America, does that mean he's a senator? Or would he be a governor?
He'd be a leader.
I'm the Senate.
That's exactly what he'd be like, too.
Carter, can you go up to the surface and get food? Because clearly, you're not the best at mining. Well, I need some.
That sucks.
I gave you two apples.
Alright, you know what? This is communism. We are starting
exactly. Your food is my food.
I have a bunch of food.
Wait, we should see how long we can survive in a communist state.
So when you get diamonds, I call first dibs because we're sharing them.
No, we all share the diamonds.
Did you guys see a mountain, by the way?
That's not very specific.
A mountain with snow on top.
Once again, that's like not very specific.
Minus 240, and then that's the X coordinates, and the Z coordinates are minus 270.
That's not very specific.
Or can you just give me your
describe course? Your surroundings to me?
Wood.
I take that back. Describe our surroundings to you. And you just said he died.
Our deaths.
While exploring the cave, I came across a minecart chest with two diamonds in it. I think Bonat's not pulling. Oh, I found diamonds.
Wait.
Actually?
Yeah.
Alright, hold on.
I got it. And being the smart man I am, I proceeded to use it on the most important item in the game, the most important piece of equipment for food gathering.
Imagine forgetting about our wife.
I'm sorry. No way, guys, she's in good hands.
Wait.
Our hands, I'm sorry.
better.
When you go to the playground in a communist society and it's like, you see the special kid like licking the slide and it's like, sorry, that's our child.
It's not my responsibility.
It's our.
That would be capitalist. It's our responsibility.
But not everything can go as well as finding diamonds in the first cave you go into. The spokes of civil war began to make themselves more evident to our emerging communist party.
There's a zombie behind you!
I don't know, you kinda pulled that bow a little bit early. I was thinking something was going on, but I guess you're right, there was a zombie.
Ooh, a spider eye.
Come on now. Oh, wait, didn't you say you had food for us? You gave me a spider eye. Come here.
I know, you can eat it. You can eat it.
I don't want this. I want good food. I don't want spider eye. Come here.
That is quality.
I want good food.
Basically drugs.
No, stop.
I want good food. Give me it. Yeah, I want good food. Give me the good food. Now, you may have noticed that the Civil War did appear to start over the lack of good food, also known as him giving me a spider eye for food. And you may be wondering, that's really how this all started? This is how we proceeded to kill each other for the next 10 minutes over this? I would say yes, because you know why? To have a good, prosperous society, you have to have a good food source. And if you don't have a good food source, you will never go anywhere. So I was just rooting out the corruption, and just saying, we need good food. After calling a truce, one party decided to log off, and the other party decided to re-gear up, head west, and find new territory to conquer. After traveling west a little bit, we came across an abandoned portal, which actually did yield some pretty decent loot for early game players. Oh, I found a portal! Hold up.
Oh, this thing is still here.
Oh, shit. Cool. There's some good stuff in here, actually.
flint steel.
Mending pant, golden pants?
Oh, nice.
And curse of binding chestplate. Alright, back to the west. No, northeast, whatever the hell I had. Oh, a fire charge. You know what that means? I'm gonna snipe some sheep. 3, 2. How do you use a fire charge?
Put it on the ground.
That's all it does?
Yeah.
Is it infinite?
No, it's a one-time use.
Oh, he's a stupid then.
Yeah.
After making an attempt to the nether in which I just proceeded to go there to die over and over again. I want to find one of this castle. Wait, why are they attacking me?
Gold? Die?
After exiting the nether, we had proceeded to come back to the overworld to be welcomed by quite a surprise. I found a pink sheep!
Those are the rarest ones.
I found one.
Slaughter it?
Nah, we need to save him. We're gonna name him Gertruda. Like the good naturalist we are, instead of letting it roam free and letting it be on its own for the rest of its life, we proceeded to dig a hole for it, punch him in it, made it so he couldn't get out, and we also spawned him a friend in just so he wouldn't get lonely.
Wait, here, I can make a pen.
This is a sign of good things to come. Alright, well, continue west.
You have fun, though. Actually, I'm just gonna spawn in a sheep, I don't even care. Alright, here, watch this. Ready? Ready?
Oh, he's not naked.
I hate you. Alright.
Yeah, he's shut this again. Sheep. Kill him.
Alright, I'll just come down here. Alright, ready? You do that, you get Jeb underscore.
Dang, imagine if we had like flashing lights and stuff. We could like put it up as a strobe light and the epileptic people would love it.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm done with them. They're boring me. Let's go look for a village. After imprisoning the sheep, we continued our search west for a village in which we could spread our communist ideals to the local population. Oh wait.
Oh, there's a village to the left, to the left. Starboard.
Once arriving in the village, like any colonial expansionist, we began to loot the village, force our ideals onto it, and kill the local leadership so we could establish our own monarchy. This is a big village, jeez. Oh, they had a chest full of cactus. Hold up, this man has shit. He just had a seizure opening the door. Holy crap. He's doing it again. Alright, boys. Wait, what the f*** are you making? No, we can't, we can't do, we have to build that in survival.
Sleeping?
The flag? Not admiring it? I worked hard on that, you know?
I did admire the flag.
You didn't, for like 5 seconds. Look at this again.
Bro,
look. Jesus!
Trying to sleep in my bed. Stupid.
I claim this tower. This is my tower. It's actually our tower. I take that back.
What I thought.
And like that, after claiming the town, like a Russian journalist reporting on government corruption, we vanished.